In previous class, we have seen linear classification with perceptron. Single layer perceptrons are only capable of learning linearly separable patterns. So, linear perceptrons cannot solve nonlinear problems. But a network with nonlinear activation function with at least one hidden layer can solve complex problems. So, to solve nonlinear complex problems, we need network with multiple neurons. First, let us see simple example. In our second lecture, we did discuss simple linear regression with linear unit. See here, our data is little nonlinear because we have used single linear unit which can capture only linear relationship. So, predictions are on the straight line. Our previous model was this one. Here we have single unit in our neural network. Let us check if we build model with more neurons in hidden layer, whether it can capture non-linearity within the data. So, let me create new model. Let us call it as model 1. Here I am creating neural network with this many layers. Here I am adding two dense layers, each of this having 64 units. In this output layer, we have one unit. If we compile this model 1 with same optimizer we did used in previous class, and here also I am using the same loss function, mean absolute error. Train this model on the entire data set. Here I am taking entire data set for 200 epochs. This model 1 is trained, so we can use this model for prediction. Let us give entire data set for the prediction. Model will predict y values. Let us call them as y predicted. If we plot the original data and model predicted data, this plotting code is written in this function. See here, this red dots are model predictions. This blue dots are original data. Still here, the model is linear. Even if we build the model with more neurons in hidden layers. This is our new model, which have two hidden layers with 64 units each. Still, it is behaving like a linear model. Neural network with linear activation and any number of hidden layers is equivalent to just a linear neural network with no hidden layer. Here we have neural network with two hidden layers. This is the input layer and this one is the output layer. X is the input and Y is the final output here. This final output Y value is computed from output from this second hidden layer. If H2 is the output from the second hidden layer, then Y will be H2 multiplied with this weight matrix W3 plus bias of this output neuron. Let us call it W3. So Y will be H2 W3 plus B3. This H2 value is computed from output from the first hidden layer, this H1 value multiplied with W2 plus bias of this neuron. Suppose we have only single neuron and its bias value is P2. Then H2 will be H1 W2 plus B2. Substitute this H2 value in this equation. Then Y will be H1 W2 plus P2 multiplied with weight matrix W3 plus B3. If you rewrite this equation, then it will be like this. Output of this hidden layer 1 will be computed from input matrix multiplied with this weight matrix W1 plus bias value of this neuron, or let us call it as B1. Substitute this H1 value in this equation, then XW1 plus B1 into W2 W3 plus B2 into W3 plus B3. The final Y value will be this one. Combination of several linear transformations can be replaced with one transformation. Combination of several bias terms is just a single bias outcome. So we can write like this, y equal to x into w dash plus b dash. Here, these two hidden layers without nonlinear activation functions are useless because composition of linear functions is a linear function. So, adding new layers does not increase the approximation power of linear neural network at all. See here, our model do not have any nonlinear activation function. That is the reason why model can capture only linear relationship. We need nonlinear activation function to approximate nonlinear functions. Activation function. It takes the output of a summation function and transform it into final output of a node. This activation function will squash the input into certain range. It will add the nonlinearity to the neural network. Some activation functions are, this is the linear activation function, f of x equal to x, which is linear one, which cannot be useful in hidden layers. This is the sigmoid activation function. Sigmoid of x will be 1 by 1 plus e power minus x. See here, whatever the x value, it will produce values between 0 and 1. If you have very high negative value, then it will be very close to 0. If you have very large positive value, it will be very close to 1. This is the rectified linear unit activation function ReLU. If x value is negative or 0, it will return simply 0. If x value is positive, it will return that positive value. This is the most recommended activation function which can be used in hidden layers. This is the tanh activation function. Tanh activation function will look like this. Its range is from minus 1 to 1, very similar to sigmoid function. And this one is the step activation function, which is used in perceptron. We told that we need nonlinear activation function to approximate nonlinear relationships. So let us add ReLU activation function in hidden layers. Let us create new model, model 2. This is very similar to previous model, but here we are adding this activation function ReLU in hidden layers. We will revisit this activation functions after discussing the backpropagation algorithm. Let me rerun this entire notebook. Now let us remove these activation functions. Now we have our model. Compile the model with same optimizer on loss function, mean absolute error, trained with the same data. Let us use this new model for the prediction. Here I am giving the entire data for the prediction. Those predicted values are stored in this variable by predicted. So let us plot this. We have this function for plotting. This first line will plot the original data, and the second line, which will take the arguments we are passing, entire data and y predictions here, x1, y1. So let me call that function. See here, the model predictions are these red dots. This is not a straight line. We have curve here, means this model is nonlinear one. If we add more hidden layers, here suppose we have added 4 hidden layers, and within each hidden layer we increase the number of nodes. Here within these 2 hidden layers, 128 nodes, and in these 2 first hidden layer and 4th hidden layer, 64 nodes. If we add more hidden layers and more nodes in each hidden layer, let us check how result will be. Compiling with same loss function and optimizer, just use entire data here. We can see here model predictions are very close to original data. Here we have more curvy. Finally, what we can conclude from this one is network with hidden layers without nonlinear activations like this are useless. They are linear models. Network with hidden layers with nonlinear activation functions such as ReLU can be used to capture the nonlinear relationships within the data. This can be nonlinear model. If you observe in our regression example, we used linear regression model to modeling the nonlinear relationship between variables TV marketing budget and sales. The simplest way of modeling nonlinear relationships with linear models is to transform the variables. See here, y equal to ae power dx and some error term u. Here we have non-linear relationship between variables x and y. If we transform these variables by applying logarithm, natural log of y equal to natural log of a plus bx plus natural log u. This is the linear function in terms of parameters, but this provides non-linear functional form. Still, model is linear. See this simple linear regression equation, which is linear in parameters. Here our parameters are w0, w1 and b. But this can fit the curve because here we have x0 with order 2. From these two examples, we can conclude that to model nonlinear relationship, still we can use linear models, but we need to transform our input variables. We already seen in our previous class, XOR function cannot be learned with single neuron. We can transform this input space into another form by adding one hidden layer to our perceptron network with ReLU as activation function. Now, these hidden units will take the input, this x0 and x1, and transform that input into another form. We can draw a network like this, the first unit within the hidden layer, which will take the inputs x0 and x1, second unit in hidden layer, which will also take the inputs x0 and x1, and the outputs of these hidden layers will be fed to the output unit, which is the perceptron. We can modify a little bit the previous network. Here, single x0 connected to the hidden units h1 and another hidden unit h2. Similarly, x1 also connected to h1 and h2. We can represent this entire network like this in simple way. Here, we draw every unit as a node in the graph, but in this style, we draw a node in the graph for each entire vector representing layer activations. This entire layer will be represented as single node in this representation. Here X is the input matrix, capital W. This one is the weight matrix between input layer and hidden layer. This W describes the mapping from X to H. This small h is the matrix of hidden activations. This small W is the weight matrix between hidden layer and output layer. This is the output layer. This small W describes the mapping from H to Y. In this kind of graph, we typically omit the intercept parameters of each layer. Means here we are not representing this bias. To describe the affine transformation from X to H. In this model, we used vector of weights and scalar of bias values. Here activation function G will be X transpose capital W plus C. Here C is the bias matrix for hidden layer. We can now specify our complete network like this. Our neural network is function in terms of this input matrix X and weight matrix W, C, small w, which is weight matrix between hidden and output layer, and the bias of the output layer, which is equal to W transpose max of 0, comma, this is the hidden activation, W transpose X plus C plus output node bias B. Don't confuse with different notations while specifying networks. A dot product of B will be equal to A into B transpose. This is the matrix notation. This is the vector dot product. Both will be equal. Sometimes we might use dot product. Sometimes we might use matrix multiplication. All these are equal. Let this W is this matrix, and the C hidden bias values is this one, this small w, which is the weights between hidden layer and output layer, is this one, and output layer bias value 0. Means network will be like this. These are the capital W input to hidden layer weights, and these are the small w value, weight matrix between hidden layer to output layer, combination of this 0 and minus 1 hidden layer bias matrix, and this is the B. Now, let us see how model processes the batch of inputs. Here, X is the matrix of batch of inputs with one example for row. This is the first example with 0, 0. The first step is to multiply the input matrix by first layer weights. This X should be multiplied with this weight matrix W. Result will be XW. This will be this matrix. Just multiply this W and X. You will get this result. Then we need to add this bias values. So add C for this first node bias value. Here it is 0. So if we add 0 for all of this, this row will not change. But for the second hidden node, we have minus 1 bias. We need to add minus 1 here. It will be minus 1. It will be again 0, 0. Here if we add minus 1, it will be 1. Then this is our final result for XW plus C. In this space, all our examples lie along the line with slope 1. But if you see our output, as we move along the line, the output needs to be begin at 0, then it raised to 1. After that, it needs to be dropped to the 0 again. Output needs to begin at 0, raise to 1, then drop back to 0. A linear model cannot implement such kind of function. So we need to transform this X space into another space H. To compute this H value, we apply rectified linear unit, which will be transforming this input into another space. So apply the ReLU for this result. Here first unit results for 4 inputs are 0, 1, 1, and for this unit minus 1, 0, 0, 1. These values are after applying this summation function. We need to apply this ReLU function now. Now H will be this matrix. See here what ReLU will do. If you have any negative values, it will return the 0. If you have positive values, it will return that positive value. See here for this, ReLU will output 0, 1, 1 and 2. For this, it will output 0 because here we have negative 1, so 0, 0 and 1. This is after applying ReLU activation function. This is also applying after ReLU activation. So our final H matrix will be this one. See here this H space 0, 0, 1, 0. This is from first node and this is H1 from second node, 1, 0 and 1, 0 again at the same place and 2, 1. These points, they no longer lie on a single straight line. See here, they lie in a space where linear model, this line, can solve the problem. We are done till here. Then we need to multiply this hidden activations with weight vector W. Our W is 1 minus 2. Just do matrix multiplication here. Our result is this one. These two inputs map to class 1 and this first and last inputs map to class 0. This multiple layer neural network has classified correctly every example in the batch. We used multiple layer neural network approach to solve the XOR, which is non-linear problem. In this, we follow two main steps. First one, we transform the original input data into new space using non-linear mapping. There we have used rectified linear unit activation. Once the data have been transformed into the new space, second step, search for a linear separating hyperplane in that new space. This hyperplane found in the new space corresponds to non-linear hyperplane in original space X, which might be something like this. For better understanding, you can assume it like the kernel trick you studied in your SVM. Here we have red and purple points on two-dimensional plane. With simple linear classifier, we cannot draw hyperplane to separate these purple points and red points. Suppose if we use SVM with this kernel, that kernel will transform this input space into three-dimensional feature space. This is minus 1, this is 0 and this is 1, this is minus 1, 0 and this is 1. See here, these red dots are close to the point 0, 0, this is the 0, 0. If we add this third dimension, a square plus b square, the value of a square plus b square will be small for this red dots. For purple points, value of a square plus b square will be high. This a square plus b square values will be plotted on the z axis. So z value for this red dots will be small and this z value for this purple points is higher. We can draw hyperplane easily like this. This is the hyperplane. These red dots are below this hyperplane. Purple dots are above this hyperplane. This hyperplane will be a circle in the original space. So this circle nonlinear one can separate these two classes easily. By adding multiple layers with nonlinear activations in neural networks also, we will transform input into another dimensions. For that new learned space, this learned head space, we can easily find hyperplane that is equivalent to nonlinear hyperplane in original space. See here, we assume this w, c and this small w unbiased values. In reality, gradient-based optimization algorithm will be used to find these model parameters. In next class, we will see gradient descent algorithm to train the neural networks.